bring a difference in the rupees. So it's been hovering below the 64 mark versus the dollar. However, this impacts the steel sector. RK Goyal, the Managing Director of Kamani Steel, now joins in. Good afternoon and thanks for joining in. We have seen the rupee appreciate by a few percentage points and now below the 64 mark. How will this impact your company?
As far as the raw materials for steel manufacturing are concerned, almost all the coking coal and coke is imported into the country, besides ferroalloys. So, with 2-3% devaluation of the rupee, it will have an impact of around 2% in the total cost of steel manufacturing. And as such, we are not able to export anything, but however, similar impact will be there on cheap imports which are coming into the country.
Well, I was aware of that. In 2015, we also saw imports grow by 50%. So, can you compare the landed price of imported steel versus domestic steel prices for us?
See, for the landed price of steel versus the manufacturing cost of Indian manufacturers, there is a difference of almost 4,000 to 5,000 rupees. And that's how almost every Indian steel manufacturer is bearing, except maybe companies which have captive iron ore. So basically they are destroying the value of the iron ore in the country. And industry is losing money very badly.
So will the devaluation of the rupee not help the domestic steel producers?
You are absolutely right. The devaluation of rupee will not make much difference. It is some trade barrier or safeguard duty or anti-dumping duty that only will help the domestic industry.
Hello, Mr. Mohan. Let's shift focus to raw materials. Any reasons that domestic iron prices sharply in 2015? So, can you compare the imported iron prices now versus the NDC prices?
You see, global price of iron ore, fines is around, say, $50, $52, and depending on the quality. As compared to that, the landed cost of iron ore in our plants of similar grade will be almost $70. So domestic iron ore is still much more expensive as compared to this international price. At the same time, if you want to import the material because of very high logistic cost, because most of the plants are landlocked, so it turns out to be still marginally more expensive.
Okay, so should we understand that the domestic iron ore is now cheaper in comparison to the landed price of imported iron ore?
Landed cost basis, marginally. Otherwise, suppose for a manufacturer in China, his landed cost of iron ore is much lower than what I get locally in my plant.
Alright, so my final question, what's your take on steel prices and demand for the financial year of $16? And is there any optimism in steel?
See, as far as the demand part is concerned, we are not seeing any positive signs in the market. It is by and large stable or in some segments it is somewhat lower. As far as the manufacturing cost is concerned, it is by and large stable. But there is tremendous pressure from the consumers about price reduction, and all of us may be forced to reduce our prices. So therefore there will be a pressure on the margins. So we don't expect 15-16 to be a great year.